مسلم قرآن اسمك I hear the calling of them With it we unite We are special only If we follow his light The way of Muhammad Calling to paradise ya Allah We are your servants, ya Allah La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasul
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, brothers and sisters and viewers around the world. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And welcome to another episode of the Servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm your host, Hisham Bella. Jazakumullahu khairan for tuning in. We are here carrying on with our discussion on the beautiful quality which those who are beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have. And that is the quality of humbleness. We're here again with our Shaykh, Shaykh Saeed Al-Gadi. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserve him. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, Shaykh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Hisham, barakallahu feek.
Jazakallahu khairan for your time. If you wouldn't mind, Shaykh, I'd just like to recap on the last episode with our viewers.
Sure.
In the last episode, we talked about a definition of humbleness and what it means to lower yourself and to really control your ego. And to lower yourself in front of Allah and His creation, and how that, even though it does not make a straight sense, but that will enable you to be honored amongst others. And the more you humble yourself, as the Shaykh, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserve him, mentioned, that the more you humble yourself, the more that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will honor you and will lift you amongst His creation. We also spoke about that, and we also reaffirmed that those who are humble are loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the aim of the show, to seek and see those actions and those qualities which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves and which will make us amongst Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's beloved servants. And we also went through many examples of the humbleness of the prophets. May Allah be pleased with them. And we saw that they were all shepherds. They all were shepherds, which is quite a lowly job or task to do, but this was all training these prophets which were sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, training them in humbleness and in responsibility. And then we went through some beautiful examples of the humbleness of the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the Prophet himself sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his humbleness and how humble he was with the rest of the companions and also the non-Muslims as well. So Jazakallah khairan, Shaykh. That was a beautiful episode. And today, inshallah ta'ala, we'd like to really shift the focus on to pride and really the dangers of pride, Shaykh. First question is, why is pride prohibited?
Jazakallah khairan. May Allah bless you. Reward you, Hisham. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Allahumma salli ala Nabiyyina Muhammad. All praise due to Allah alone. We praise Him, thank Him, seek His guidance and His forgiveness. I repent to Him. Seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our souls and our sinful deeds. And may Allah's peace and blessing be upon Him. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
First of all, let me emphasize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those who are humble, and He hates those who are arrogant, those who are proud. Allah ta'ala in the Quran said, when He spoke about those whom He loves, He said, يحبهم ويحبونه أذلة على المؤمنين. Those whom Allah Ta'ala loves and they love Him, one of their main attributes, they are humble. They are humble towards the believers. And then, when He spoke about those who are arrogant, He mentioned in many verses in the Quran that He hates them.
إن الله لا يحب من كان مختالا فخورا.
Allah Ta'ala doesn't like anyone. Allah Ta'ala doesn't like anyone who is arrogant or boasting. Allah Ta'ala loves those who are humble. Those who are humble. So the question was,
why is pride prohibited?
it is prohibited in Islam and forbidden in Islam, because pride is only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah ta'ala is the only one who deserves to be proud. And therefore, any of his creation should not at all be proud or arrogant. Allah ta'ala, the one who created you, brought you into existence, is the one who's supposed to be proud only. And it is one of his names, Al-Mutakabbir, one of his attributes and one of his names, that his name Al-Mutakabbir. And that's why the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the sound hadith said that Allah ta'ala, the Almighty, said Al-Izzu Rida'i. Al-Izzu Izari وَالْكِبْرِيَاءُ رِدَاءِ مَنْ نَازَعَنِي فِيهِ مَعَذَّبْتُهُ. It is in Sahih Muslim that honor is my lower garment. Is like my lower garment. Honor is like my lower garment. And arrogance is my cloak or my cover. And whoever vies with me in regard in any one of them, I will punish him.
Sheikh, can I just ask, is it not somewhat quite rude or belittling to call Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala arrogant and proud?
If someone,
I know that this is a name that he has given it to himself, subhanahu wa ta'ala, but you may be able to open this topic up, inshallah, for us.
First of all, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala named himself with this name.
Yes.
And if someone deserves to be proud, deserves to be proud, then he has the full right to be proud. But the problem is, if someone doesn't deserve to be proud, if someone who's weak,
yes, yes,
who is dependent,
yes,
okay, and he is proud. Proud of what? You are proud of what? In fact, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is an attribute of perfection. To be proud, because he is the one who created everything, who did everything. And to be humble towards whom? Why should he be humble towards whom?
Sah. Because there is none higher than Allah.
Everything is under him. Are you following?
Yes.
It is for the creation to be humble is good, because we are all creation.
Are we all weak and dependent?
We are all weak and dependent, yeah. But Allah Ta'ala is the Lord of creation. Why should he be humble towards us? He doesn't have to. In fact, it is a sign of his perfect attributes that he is mutakabbir. He is proud. Does that make sense?
Yes, jazakallahu khair.
Yes. Inshallah ta'ala. Barakallahu
fiqh. Barakallahu fiqh. So, pride, Sheikh. Is pride from the major sins? Will it prevent you from entering Jannah?
It is one of the major sins. And you can imagine that the devil was sacked from the heaven because of pride.
Yes.
He was proud.
That's a very good point.
He didn't disobey Allah Ta'ala because he was lazy. No, he said, I'm better than him. Better than Adam alayhi salam. خَلَقْتَنِي مِنْ نَارُ وَخَلَقْتَنِي You've created him from mud and you've created me from fire. So he was arrogant. Allah Ta'ala said to him, you have no right to be arrogant here.
And is he considered as the source of all pride?
Exactly.
And arrogance.
This arrogance is a source of many evil actions. Belittling people, despising people. And that's why you see that the hasad, which is envy, is initiated from arrogance. You say, how come so-and-so has this and this and I don't have it? How come he has this? How come they have this and I don't have it? Okay, most of the evil actions are initiated from arrogance. Okay, let's go back to the topic now.
Yeah,
will it deprive him from
entering Jannah?
Entering Jannah, it will. And you can imagine if I tell you that you probably won't believe that if you have an atom's weight of arrogance in your heart, you won't enter Jannah. Subhanallah. لا يدخل الجنة من كان في قلبه مثقال ذرة من كبر. The one who has an atom's weight in his heart of arrogance, he won't enter Jannah. Okay? But some ulama said that the Nabi ﷺ means that he won't enter Jannah at the beginning. He will be punished. Because most people have arrogance in their heart. But we have to control it. We have to manage it. We have to trick ourselves to get rid of it. It's hard to have nothing in your heart, but you have to work towards it. We have to work towards eliminating any arrogance in our hearts. Okay? And Nabi Sallam, we spoke about the people of the hellfire. We described them. He said that, shall I tell you about the people of the hellfire? Shall I describe to you the dwellers of the hellfires? The dwellers of the hellfire. The companion said, Ya Rasulullah, yes, tell us about them. He said, everyone, kullu utullin jawadin mustakbir. Everyone who's harsh, violent, and arrogant. These are the people of the hellfire who have these qualities and these attributes. And then Allah Ta'ala made it very clear that the Jannah is for those who are humble, those who are submissive, and those who have no arrogance in their hearts. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, when he spoke about the arrogance of Qarun. Qarun was the people of Musa. إِنَّ قَارُونَ عَلَى فِي الْأَرْضِ إِنَّ قَارُونَ كَانَ مِنْ قَوْمِ مُوسَى فَبَغَى عَلَيْهِمْ Qarun was from the people of Musa. And he was arrogant to Musa. وَآتَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْكُنُوزِ مَا إِنَّ مَفَاتِحَهُ لَتَنُوءُ بِالْعُصْبَةِ أُولِي الْقُوَّةِ We gave him treasures, which their keys will be heavy for the person who is of strong built body to carry. He won't be able to carry it. The keys of the treasures that he had. إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ قَوْمُهُ لَا تَفْرَحْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْفَرِحِينَ His people said to him, don't be exalted. Allah doesn't like those who exalt themselves. But he was very proud, very arrogant. Allah Ta'ala once, then he said that Allah Ta'ala caused the earth to swallow him. Allah Ta'ala exterminated him and his wealth. At the end, Allah Ta'ala finished the story by saying, تِلْكَ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةِ This is Jannah. This is the hereafter. نَجَالُهَا لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُرِيدُونَ عُلُوًا فِي الْأَرْضِ We will only make it and we'll only give it to those who don't want to be arrogant in the land.
So that means those who are arrogant will not enter Jannah, subhanAllah.
Will not enter Jannah. نَجْعَلُهَا لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُرِيدُونَ عُلُوًا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فَسَادًا
SubhanAllah.
وَلَعَاقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ And the good ending is for the pious ones.
JazakAllahu khairan, Shaykh. InshaAllah, we'll take a quick break.
InshaAllah.
And we'll return back and really delve into this topic further, InshaAllah.
InshaAllah.
And we'll try and, InshaAllah, maybe gain some advice from you about how to, InshaAllah, take this quality away from us and make us amongst those who are humble and beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, we'll see you straight after this break, InshaAllah ta'ala. Please stay tuned. Barakallahu feekum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choose whom He wills subhanahu wa ta'ala for His mercy, for His messengership, for the revelation to be revealed. This is not for the human beings to make that decision. If a person would turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely, truthfully, asking for forgiveness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised to forgive. We have as Muslims a duty, and that is to recite the book of Allah, to ponder over the verses, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to act according to the Quran. The mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encompasses everything, but it who would this mercy will be for? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent to all mankind. So the ummah, or the people of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, are all mankind since the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam till the day of judgment. Why waste our life without getting to know every verse in the Quran, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us?
The entire staff at Hoda would like to wish you a wonderful and blessed Ramadan.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brothers and sisters. Before the break, we went through the issue of pride and how much of a danger it is to our heart and how it will prevent us from entering Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to enter Jannah and not prevent us and not deny us that great place in paradise. Ameen, ameen. Sheikh, you spoke about the danger of pride and arrogance. And subhanallah, you mentioned the story of Nimrud.
And Qarun,
sorry. Yes, and the reason why I said Nimrud is because as you were talking about Qarun, I remembered Nimrud, and I also remembered Fir'aun and Abu Jahl and others who were too arrogant to believe in the message of the prophets that were sent to them. So subhanallah, we see, you find that those people who denied the messages, the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the messengers, one of the main causes of their denial is their pride. Because they may have believed, they may have realized that this is the truth, but they were too proud to believe in it. Is that the case?
This is the case. You mentioned Fir'aun.
Yes.
Fir'aun is a good example of pride and arrogance. Fir'aun knew that Musa alayhi salam was speaking the truth. And he knew from the bottom of his heart that he is not a Lord. But he was claiming that he is a Lord. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, إِنَّ فِرْعَوْنَ عَلَى فِي الْأَرْضِ. Indeed, Fir'aun has exalted himself or exalted himself on earth. وَجَعَلَ أَهْلَهَا شِيَعًا. And he divided his people of his empire or his kingdom, into classes. يَسْتَضْعِفُ طَائِفَةً مِّنْهُمْ. And he used to lower and treat with a lower treatment certain people of them, or certain classes of them. So Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, عَلَى فِي الْأَرْضِ. And another verse Allah Ta'ala said, فَاسْتَكْبَرَ هُوَ وَجُنُودُهُ. And he was arrogant, him and his soldiers, the army. So it was the arrogance that prevented him from taking or entering into the right religion and responding to Allah's messengers. And that's why because he knew that Musa alayhi salam was truthful, that's why he tried to believe in him at the moment of death. He said, آمنت أنه الذي أن آمنت آمنت أنه لا إله إلا الذي آمن بنو إسرائيل وأنا هو المسلمين. He said, I believe in Allah, the one whom Musa alayhi salam believed in. But it was too late. He's about to die.
And even in this statement, there is a certain level of pride.
Allah
because he said that I believed in the what the Banu Israel, the children of Israel, believed in. He did not say, I believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Allah musta'an. Allah musta'an.
Subhanallah.
If someone grew up in this attribute, pride, it will reflect in everything that he says.
SubhanAllah. Yeah. Sheikh, what will cause pride and arrogance?
One of the main reasons that will cause pride and arrogance is that if someone is forgetting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if someone is heedless of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, heedless of his Lord, heedless of who brought him into existence, that will make him proud. If someone is heedful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his attributes, and he knows why he is here in this world, he's here to worship Allah ta'ala, to become a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which we all strive to be servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If this is clear in his mind, then he won't have the arrogance in his heart. No one will have arrogance in his heart. But if someone is heedless of this concept, someone is forgetting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala totally, of course he will fall in arrogance. If someone is heedless of the of his reality, how did he come into existence? Who brought him into existence?
أولا يذكر الإنسان أنا خلقناه من قبل ولم يكن شيئا. Can't man remember that we created him before he was nothing? Once you think and imagine and comprehend that you were nothing, then you will realize that you have no reason to be proud or to be arrogant. You were nothing. You were non-being. And Allah Ta'ala brought you into existence. And if this is the case, then you should be very humble. So forgetting Allah Ta'ala, forgetting the reality of yourself, how you came to existence, and at the same time, one of the reasons that make a person proud is subhanAllah, the people. When people praise you. Or if you praise yourself. When we praise ourselves, or we seek people's praise, that will make us proud. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran commanded us not to praise ourselves. He says subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَلَا تُزَكُّوا أَنفُسَكُمْ هُوَ أَعْلَمُ بِمَنِ اتَّقَى. Don't praise yourselves. Allah ta'ala knows the one who is pious and the one who is righteous. أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ يُزَكُّونَ أَنفُسَهُمْ. Can you see those people who praise themselves? أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ يُزَكُّونَ أَنفُسَهُمْ بَلِ اللَّهُ يُزَكِّي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah Ta'ala is the one who praises whoever he wants.
Subhanallah.
وَلَا يُظْلَمُونَ فَتِيلًا. And they won't be wronged at all in Allah's judgment. Subhanallah. So therefore, when we praise ourselves, that will initiate the pride in our hearts. We should not praise ourselves, neither that we should praise others. Praise others, unless if we know for sure that our praise to them will not cause them, will not make them proud.
And that's what you mean by that, Sheikh, to praise them in their face, in their presence.
In their presence, yeah.
It's allowed for us to praise them in their absence.
Exactly, it's allowed in their absence, and it's allowed in their presence if we are sure that our praise will not make them proud. Will not affect their worship, okay? Will not cause them to do negative things. And that's why the Nabi Sallam used to praise certain Sahaba. He used to praise certain Sahaba in their faces. For example, he used to praise Umar, he used to praise Abu Bakr. He said, Khayr Ummati Abu Bakr. Okay? And he used to praise certain Sahaba in their faces. He said to Ashad ibn Abd al-Qais, you have two qualities which Allah Ta'ala loves, which is clemency and tolerance. So he used to praise certain Sahaba in their faces because he knows that they that his praise will not affect them. Sheikh, that will encourage them, in fact.
Naam.
To do good Mashallah. Deeds.
Mm-hmm. That's really the, it shows the wisdom of the Prophet with his mm-hmm. companions and
exactly.
how he,
exactly.
as much as possible, tried to instill confidence within them.
Exactly.
And shows,
yeah, go on.
Sorry, it just shows how we should praise maybe our children. It's and we should not put them down, and we should praise mm-hmm. them to try and, you know, instill good levels of confidence within them, inshallah.
Exactly, very good example. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to praise Uthman, for example. He said, Uthman fil Jannah, Umar fil Jannah, Abu Bakr fil Jannah. What a great praise is this, that you are from the people of Jannah, walking on earth and you are from Jannah. You've been given a certificate to enter Jannah. But nevertheless, Uthman used to spend the whole night and read the whole Quran.
Subhanallah.
Okay, but as well, another thing that the ulama said that Rasulullah gave them the indication that they will enter Jannah, but he didn't give them indication that they will be safe from the hellfire.
Oh, subhanAllah. To keep them working, to keep them working hard, subhanAllah. Sheikh, and to end, I would like to ask you, how can we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hates proud people. If you could mention, how can we avoid pride and become of those who are beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the humble ones? How can we gain this?
Inshallah, first of all, we should not, as I said before, we should realize the reality of ourselves, the reality of our creation, and we should as well understand the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ. And people have not esteemed Allah as He has the right to be esteemed. والأرض جميعا قبضته يوم القيامة.
And the whole earth will be his handful in the day of judgment.
والسماوات مطويات بيمينه.
And the seven heavens will be folded up in his right hand.
سبحانه وتعالى عما يشركون.
Glory be to him and exalted he is from what they ascribe to him. So we should understand the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That will help us to eliminate the pride that we have in our hearts. Inshallah ta'ala, this is one of the main issues that will help us to, main factors that will help us to avoid pride, inshallah ta'ala.
Jazakallahu khairan, Shaykh.
Barakallahu.
It's been beautiful having you here. And we've learned so much, subhanAllah. And we only hope at the end, and I'm sure the viewers would hope that as well, we only hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really enable us to become of those who take the best of advice and follow it and act upon it. Because if we do not, then it will become a witness on us on Yawm al-Qiyamah. We seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from that. Just finally,
yeah, something at the end.
Yes, please.
Just to remind ourselves that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hates those who are arrogant to a degree and extent that he won't look at them in the hereafter. They will be gathered in the hereafter as small as the atom, and people will step on them. And it's a sound hadith. Allah ta'ala will not look at them.
Subhanallah.
Will not look at their faces.
Subhanallah. Jazakallahu khairan.
Barakallahu.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take all pride away from our heart and help us to gain the state of becoming humble to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, thanks for joining us. Unfortunately, our time has ended. Inshallah ta'ala, we'll join you again with the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and another attribute and quality of those who are beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I've been your host, Hisham Bella, and our Shaykh today was Shaykh Saeed Al-Qadi. May Allah reward him. Until next time, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
I am a Muslim, Quran is my guide. I hear the calling of them, with it we unite. We are special only if we follow his light, the way of Muhammad, calling to paradise. Ya Allah, we are your servants, Ya Allah. La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah.